Anton Scoro with Fisticuff Radio and Pro MMA Now, standing next to a guy that's a legend on the ground. I guess we can say that, a legend. Coach Robert Drysdale. Coach, how you doing?
Great.
So I've got to ask, man, what brings you out to Tuff-N-Uff tonight?
I'm coaching Jordan McDonald. It's her second fight at Tuff-N-Uff, and I'm excited to be in her corner. She's been working at the gym for a while now, and I'm looking forward to this fight. She's ready.
All right, Coach, so I want to ask this, man. Talk to me a little bit about the difference between being a competitor, not only in the MMA game and as well, you know, on the mat, but now transitioning over into a coaching role.
I think it went well. Like, I've always watched the sport. I enjoy it. I'm actively involved in the sport. I'm always training. I guess I'm an open-minded guy. I'm willing to learn from everyone, and I'm willing to admit that I'm wrong. I'm willing to change things if they have to be changed. I'm willing to assimilate aspects of other martial arts into what I already know. And I'm passionate about teaching, you know, so I think all these elements make for a coach. And it's something I enjoy. It's something I like. You know, one of my fighters wins with a move I taught him like a while ago, it's like, yes. It's almost like, you know, I feel like the win is mine in a way.
All right. So, Coach, you bring up a word that doesn't get used a lot, or I guess it's starting to get used a little bit less, and that's martial arts. You know, I always say that, you know, the wrestlers are starting to come over, the boxers are starting to come over. We're starting to get away from a true mixed martial artist background, I think, sometimes. Do you feel that way? I mean, do you feel like sometimes people forget that this also is a sport for martial artists and that attitude needs to be brought with it?
I think the confusion is the term martial art. If you think about it, none of them are martial arts. None of them have to do anything with war. You know, if you're a soldier, you're a martial artist, if you really think about it. But I see them all as sports, and I don't put wrestling in a different category than boxing or jiu-jitsu or karate or whatever. It's just they have different skill sets. You know, at the end of the day, they're just skill sets in order to learn how to hand-to-hand combat. That's what it is. I think hand-to-hand combat or combat would be a better term than martial art. But I just don't see it like that. To me, it's just, they just have different skill sets and they have different rules, and that means that the sport evolves in different directions, you know. If wrestling had kimuras and chokes, it would have evolved in a different way and it would look a lot more like what we call submission wrestling today. So just like the rules kind of determine what direction the sport will take, and that's what I believe. I don't, you know, I use the term martial art because it's a generic term, but if you really think about it, it doesn't really mean anything.
All right, so I've got two more questions for you. Big move over to your gym just recently, Gil Martinez, excellent guy, good friend of the show. Want to ask you a little bit about that move and how things have been, you know, on your side with having a guy like Gil in the gym now.
Oh, it's a lot of fun, man. Gil's been coaching me for a while now. He's a great boxing coach. We get along, and he's been in the gym for like 3-4 months now maybe. And we just moved to a bigger location too, and it's great to have him over. You know, everyone likes his classes. He's, you know, he coaches from kids to professional fighters. So, you know, it was a great move, and I'm happy to have him in there.
All right, so you mentioned a word that's going to obviously have to do with my last question, and that's professional fighter. Obviously not just a coach, still a professional fighter. Just had to pull out of your last fight due to an injury. Talk to me a little bit about the injury and when we might be able to see you back in the ring.
Well, the plan is to fight again in July, same opponent, same show. You know, I had an injury that I kind of underestimated it. And I'm like, yeah, it's going to heal. And then 2 months went by and it hadn't healed. And you know what? This gives me, I'm doing the math here, it's going to give me 3 weeks to train. My opponent's been preparing for like 12 weeks. So, like, you know, I don't want to give him that chance. You know, I want to have a 2-month camp. I think that's fair. I think 8 weeks preparation is fair. And, you know, I'm very conservative in that sense. You know, I'm not the kind of guy that takes a short notice fight. I don't like that. I like to prepare mentally, physically, technically for a fight, and regardless of who I'm fighting. It could be UFC title fight, it could be an amateur fight, it could be a jiu-jitsu match. I like to prepare, and I feel like I couldn't prepare the way I would like to because of the injury. So just, you know what, I don't want to walk in there 80%. I just don't, you know. So I just wait a couple more months and, you know, fight in July.
I love it. Well, guys, once again, Coach, I'll give you a second. Tell them where they can follow you on Twitter and plug anything you want.
All right, check out my my website, drysdalejiu-jitsu.com. Follow me on Twitter, at Robert Drysdale, Facebook. And, any of you guys, always welcome to the gym. Come check it out. It's on Rainbow and Sahara. Come check it out. Everyone's welcome.
Hey, I'll give this man a plug real quick. Best jiu-jitsu in Las Vegas. If you're not down there and you're training somewhere else, go check out a class. You never know what you might learn. Once again, it's Anton Scoro with Fisticuff Radio and Pro MMA. We're out.